baby, calm down, calm down. Yo, this your body, it puts in my heart for lockdown, for lockdown, oh lockdown. Yo, you sweet life, Fanta, Fanta. If I tell you, say I love you, no day for me, young girl, oh young girl. No, tell me, no, 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 oh, 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 oh. Baby, come give me your lo, 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 lo.
Hi guys, you're Miss Boca High.
And you're Mr. Boca High.
And we're going to be doing announcements this morning. Thanks.
The Great Migration. The Great Migration was the relocation of more than 6 million Black Americans from the rural South to the cities of the North, Midwest, and West from about 1916 to 1970, driven from their homes by unsatisfactory economic opportunities and harsh segregationist laws. Many Black Americans headed north, where they took advantage of the needs for industrial workers that arose during the First World War. How did African Americans move in masses from the rural South? They took trains traveling to destinations such as Chicago and New York City. The people who worked on those trains were called Pullman porters. At the time, this was considered a well-paying, high-profile position.
In the 19-teens and 20s, a large number of African Americans moved from the South to other parts of the country. Why did they move? What kind of impact did this have on the nation? In 1900, most African Americans in the United States lived in southern states. In fact, 90% of the African American population still lived in the South. However, many began to move into northern and midwestern states, such as Michigan, Illinois, Pennsylvania, and New York. The reasons they were moving varied from family to family. In some cases, they were hoping to find jobs in steel mills, automobile factories, meat packing plants, or working for the railroad. Some were searching for better schools and education opportunities. Others were hoping to escape the racism and violence that African Americans were experiencing in the South. Most who left the South were heading for larger northern cities: Chicago, New York City, Detroit, Philadelphia, Pittsburgh, and Cleveland all experienced significant surges in population. For example, in 1910, the African American population of Detroit was approximately 6,000. By 1930, this number had increased to 120,000. Nationwide, only an estimated 740,000 African Americans lived outside of the South in 1900. As the 20th century progressed, this number eventually rose to more than 10 million living in other regions of the country. The Great Migration was one of the largest and fastest movements ever by a group of people who were moving from one part of a nation to another. This is especially true when considering that the movement was not caused by some kind of immediate threat or danger. This migration had many different ramifications for the nation. As Black populations rose, many northern cities became increasingly more integrated. African Americans were working alongside recent European immigrants as well as other white residents. These cities also became important centers for African American culture. Newspapers, churches, businesses, and political organizations were all established by African Americans as part of a movement to redefine Black culture. Harlem became the center of much of this activity. Musicians, artists, and writers flocked to the area, bringing about the era that would eventually become known as the Harlem Renaissance.
She's just a girl and she's on fire, hotter than a fantasy.
Hi, Bobcats!
Here are a few of this year's most streamed songs and newest releases. First off, we have Sick Season by Noah Kahan.
But it's the season
second,
of the
we have I Remember Everything by Zach Bryan.
Pictures and past.
We have Greedy by Tate McRae.
I hope you enjoyed hearing about some of the top jams of this year
and how the tunes of our music followed throughout the decades. Bye, Bobcats!
Bobcats! Boca High Chorus will be selling our new Valentine's Day grams. Phone grams will be $4, song grams will be $6, and gift grams will be $8. We're selling it now through February the 13th.
Online.
Period.
As the first 60,000 people in the U.S. to receive an Apple Vision Pro tomorrow,
we wanted you all to leave your thoughts on the first true spatial video headset.
While we are not born to see the release of the iPhone, Apple Vision Pro is set to be the next big thing in tech.
We've collected several viewpoints on this topic already. We now like to invite you all to watch the video here on your own time.
So scan this QR code.
And leave your opinion wherever it is. Yeah.
Experience it for yourself. It's almost like peering into a moment in time.
It's exactly like that.
On a piece of invisible string.
All right.
So the first thing you're gonna do is you're gonna scale up the screen so it really takes over your space.
Like this?
Bobcats, it's Miss Silver Smith. Let's pick this week's winners for Bobcat Rap. We've got Sunny and Layra. Congratulations, guys. And continue to be respectful, accountable, and purposeful.
Hey guys, we're here. We're gonna get this week's rap winner.
Sunny in here?
Hi. You won Bobcat Rap!
You won!
not gonna go and surprise Mr. Fritz with his Bobcat rap raffle. Wait, let's go see. Mr. Fritz, how are you?
I'm above ground.
All right, well, Mr. Fritz, thank you so much. You actually won our Bobcat Rap Teacher Raffle win for the month. Give it up for Mr. Fritz. This is for nominating great students for being respectful, accountable, and purposeful. So thank you, Mr. Fritz.
Appreciate you.
Senior prom is coming, starting April 5th on Friday at 7:30 p.m.
So if you're bringing someone from out of school, make sure to grab a form from the office or Ms. Dice.
Hi, I'm Destiny, and I'm here with
Ms. Dice.
And she's going to tell you a little bit about prom this year.
Hi, so I'm the prom sponsor for Boca High Senior Prom. On Thursday, we will be delivering invitations to all the seniors at Boca High. And we will be giving out the invitations as well as the out-of-school guest form. And the rules, which are very important, and also all the information about buying prom tickets that start on Thursday on School Cash Online. We will be distributing the tickets through English classes or through third hour, and anybody who would like to bring an out-of-school guest must get the form approved by Mr. Michaels before purchasing the ticket, and there's a separate spot on School Cash Online for that. And if you have any other questions, you can contact me. I'm in room 5106.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. Looking forward to giving out the invitations.
Bye, Bobcats.
And ladies, if you already have your prom dress, make sure to go onto Instagram, look up, I think it's Boca High Senior Prom 24, not positive though, and submit your dress so you can see what the other girls are wearing to maybe make sure we don't buy the same dresses, but that's only if you'd like to.
Hi, and please make sure you sign up for our Instagram account for dresses. It is Boca High Prom 2024. Thank you.
And sorry, men, there's no Instagram account for us, but have fun with the men's warehouse suits. The cheer competition squad won first place at the recent competition, so here are some interviews.
With them.
With them.
To them.
Yes.
Oh, I think that I found myself a cheerleader. She is always right there when I need her. Oh, I think that I found myself a cheerleader. She is always right there.
So, how was the season?
It was really good.
I really liked it, yeah. It was really good.
It had a little bit of a rough start.
We definitely had our ups and downs, but we definitely came through.
Yeah.
That's good with the first place.
Mm-hmm.
So do we expect you guys back as cheerleaders next year as seniors?
Yeah.
Definitely.
I can't see myself not doing it.
I'm excited to do it next year.
That's good.
So do you guys know what colleges you guys are going to, and would you pursue cheer in college as well?
I'm rooting for UM, and yes, I am doing cheer.
I'm also maybe UM, FAU, things still in Florida. And of course, I will be doing it throughout college.
So what advice do you have in incoming cheerleaders for next year, some freshmen?
I say to be confident no matter what, even if you're nervous, if you're like scared they're going to judge you. They're not. Like, just do what you love to do and really just be outgoing.
It can be really hard at times, but just be really confident and put yourself out there.
Yeah.
That's good. Well, that's all the time we have today. Thank you, Bobcats.
Bye, Bobcats.
Bye.